Hi, welcome to this edition of What's Happening at Tri-City Medical Center. I'm John Bonasaro, and I'll be your host for this program, made in collaboration with KOCT, North County's Channel, and Tri-City Medical Center. Our goal is to keep you informed about health issues, events, and services at your local medical center, and to provide you with information for a healthy lifestyle. This episode features Dr. Jason Curry, who practices physical medicine and rehab at Tri-City Medical Center. Dr. Curry specializes in non-surgical approaches for the treatment of cervical, thoracic, and lumbar spine pain, as well as joint pain. His goal is to help restore physical function and activities of daily living by improving the quality of life for his patients. Welcome, Dr. Curry.
Thank you.
Let's start by finding out what exactly is physical medicine and a rehabilitation doctor.
So a PM&R doctor is a type of doctor who has gone through 4 years of medical school, and then they go on to complete a four-year residency training in the field of physical medicine and rehabilitation, also known as physiatry. Relative to other specialties, our specialty is sort of younger and newer. We trace our origins back to the 1920s when tuberculosis and polio diseases were rampant, causing a lot of deconditioning of folks. And so the field of physical medicine was created to try to help those patients regain their strength. And then later in the early 1940s, when our vets were coming back from World War II, the field rehabilitation medicine was created with the goal of trying to oversee the veterans' rehab process and recovering from their injuries in their wounds sustained in war. And so in the late 1940s, because of the similarities between physical medicine and rehab medicine, the two fields were combined to form physical medicine and rehab to what it is today. So you can think of our PM&R doctor as a combination of several different specialties, such as internal medicine, orthopedics, neurology, a little bit of sports medicine combined with an emphasis on physical therapy. And so you get a unique standpoint from a PM&R doctor's treatment options. In residency, a PM&R doctor will learn how to take care of patients with brain injuries, spinal cord injuries, strokes, wound care, pain medicine. And so the scope of practice of a PM&R doctor can vary widely depending on which area of specialty that particular PM&R doctor wants to emphasize in the practice.
Let's flesh this out a bit. So what does an interventional physiatrist do?
So an interventional physiatrist relies on doing interventions. They master interventions in trying to help that patient recover from their pain and improve their quality of life and improve their function. In general, an interventional physiatrist can master things like joint injections, muscle injections, and spine injections, again, with the emphasis of trying to decrease pain and thereby improve the patient's quality of life.
Describe what an EMG nerve conduction study is.
So that's a type of test that physiatrist will frequently perform on patients. An EMG can be thought of as a nerve test to look at the function of the nervous system, whereas an EKG is a study of the heart, an EMG will study the nervous system. And so the test is performed in two different parts. The first part consists of placing small electrodes on the body. It's the same kind of electrodes that are placed for, say, an EKG. And then the nerves are stimulated. And when the nerves are stimulated, the machine can record the response of the nerves, and that will tell you about how the nerve is functioning. The second part of the test uses a small needle the size of an acupuncture needle to listen to some of the sounds of the muscles, and that, again, will tell you about the health of the nerves.
Is this a test that's done early in the process? Is this part of the diagnostic process?
It is, and a lot of times these tests will be ordered by other physicians other than the PM&R doctor. For instance, say an orthopedic surgeon is evaluating for someone that they suspect has carpal tunnel syndrome, which is when a nerve gets entrapped in the wrist. An EMG test can help decipher if that is indeed happening. And so other instances where an EMG test may be ordered would be if a patient is complaining of numbness or tingling in their feet. An EMG test can look for possible peripheral neuropathy. Sometimes people will have a pinched nerve in their spine that will send pain down the legs or down the arms. And so an EMG test can help assess for that to help get a diagnosis and potentially a prognosis.
What are some of the things that should trigger a patient to think about going down this route and seeing someone like yourself?
Anytime someone's in a lot of pain for a long time, months, years, or pain that is affecting their quality of life, it's a good idea to see a health professional, specifically if that pain involves the musculoskeletal system, so back, neck, arms, legs. An interventional physiatrist may be someone that can help you. The interventional physiatrist will help figure out, number one, what's going on, so they'll help get a diagnosis, as well as discuss treatment options and provide education about that particular diagnosis.
Well, speaking of treatment options, what are some of the options you offer?
Treatment options can vary pretty widely depending on what the particular diagnosis is. One of the first line treatments that I always recommend to my patients is physical therapy. In fact, physical therapy is the best long-term non-surgical treatment option for someone's pain, particularly if it's a musculoskeletal pain. And so the goal of everything I do is to try to help someone get in with a physical therapist to get on a daily home exercise program if they're not on one. That's the best long-term non-surgical solution for musculoskeletal pain. And so sometimes I may rely on a medication or some type of injection to help decrease the pain to, again, reach that goal of getting someone active again and getting someone on an exercise program.
You know, it seems like one of the biggest decisions is surgery or not. So how is that decision made? Is that made in conjunction with someone like yourself?
Yeah, so the question of surgery versus non-surgery can be a very complex question. It requires you to individualize your treatment plan to that particular patient. And so it's important that a doctor looks thoroughly into what's going on to discuss possible treatment options. The decision for surgery can be based off of how much pain someone's in. And additionally, you have to look at what other things are going on in that patient's life. There are a lot of other medical conditions that you have to take into consideration when deciding if someone should have surgery or not. And so I think that's a big advantage of coming to our group at Orthopedic Specialists in North County, is that we have non-surgical specialists such as myself working alongside surgical specialists, where we have orthopedic surgeons who have subspecialized in virtually every aspect of the body. And so together as a team, we all collaborate with each other to come up with the best treatment option for the patient.
Just to be clear, surgery doesn't mean you're not someone they should see. It's not just the decision whether to have surgery or not. You offer after-surgery treatment as well.
Correct. And again, I have to emphasize that's an advantage of coming to our group, is that we all work together as a team to help that patient get better.
So how would someone get to see you and your group? Is a referral needed?
Sometimes it really depends on a particular insurance. And so our group can help with that. Someone would want to visit our website at orthonorthcounty.com. There's a lot of information on that, and we can help someone get in to see us.
And what can people expect in an initial visit?
At the initial visit, we'll take a good thorough history. We want to figure out what's going on with your pain, why you're having that pain, and so basic imaging such as x-rays may be ordered at that initial visit. And then we'll come up with a further plan for treatment, which may include ordering further testing such as the EMG or an MRI to further figure out what's going on. And then once we get that diagnosis, we'll come up with a treatment plan.
Well, thanks for that great information. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
For more information on spine and joint health, please visit tricitymed.org.